Hello everyone, once again welcome you all in the online lecture series, and we are talking about a chapter that is volumetric analysis. In volumetric analysis, we know that there are four types of reactions are studied, that is neutralization reactions, complexometric titrations, redox titrations and precipitation titration. In previous lectures we discussed about the acid base titrations, complexometric titration and redox titration. In redox titration, we discuss about a preparation of standard KMnO4 solution, preparation of standard potassium permanganate solution. It is a secondary standard solution, and how to standardize this potassium permanganate solution. We also discuss about a example of redox titration. Here we are determining the strength of H2O2 in the given sample in terms of normality, in terms of gram per liter, and in terms of volume. So in this previous lecture we discuss about a redox titration. So that means in previous lecture we discuss about the applications of this redox titration, how the potassium permanganate is used as a self indicator as well as titrant in the solution, and how to determine the strength of H2O2 solution. Now in this lecture we will discuss about a fourth type of titration, that is called as a precipitation titration. What is precipitation titration? Precipitation titration is nothing but, in this reaction the product is formed as a precipitate. When two reagents are titrated with each other, then the product will be formed in terms of a precipitate, and that is called as a precipitation titration. So these are the reactions, those which are involved in the formation of precipitate, and in most of the reactions or in most of the titrometric analysis in the precipitation reaction, silver nitrate is used as a precipitating reagent, because silver can form a precipitate with elements, and therefore in most of the important precipitation reaction silver nitrate can be used as a precipitating agent, and hence precipitation reactions are also known as a argentimetric processes. These are also called as a argentimetric titrations, or these are also called as a argentimetric processes. So what is precipitation reaction? Suppose we see the precipitation reaction, that means the titration between 0.1 molar silver nitrate solution and 0.1 molar sodium chloride solution. If we see the reaction, when silver nitrate will be react with this sodium chloride, it gives formation of a white precipitate of silver chloride. And how the silver chloride is formed? That means the consider the change in ionic concentration which occur during the titration. That means if we take a 100 ml of 0.1 molar NaCl solution with 0.1 molar silver nitrate solution, that means if we titrate 100 ml 0.1 molar NaCl solution with 0.1 molar silver nitrate solution, then the solubility product for this silver chloride at room temperature is 1.2 into 10 raised to minus 10. That means if the ionic product is exceed than solubility product, then the precipitate of silver chloride will be formed, and that means the initial concentration of Cl minus ion in the solution, that means we are taking a 100 ml 0.1 molar NaCl solution and its concentration is 0.1 molar, and therefore if we find out the concentration of chloride ion in terms of PCl minus, that is equal to 1. What is PCl? PCl is nothing but the negative logarithm of Cl minus ion. Substitute the value of Cl minus ion is 0.1, then log of 0.1 is equal to minus 1, minus minus becomes 1, and therefore PCl minus is equal to 1. Then after addition of 50 ml 0.1 molar silver nitrate solution into the 100 ml 0.1 molar NaCl solution, right, a 50 ml of 0.1 molar NaCl solution will be remains in the solution as it is, and the total volume is equal to 150 ml, because we are taking a 100 ml NaCl solution and we are adding 50 ml 0.1 molar silver nitrate solution. Among these, 50 ml will be consumed and the 50 ml will be remains as it is, but the total volume of this solution is equal to 150 ml, and therefore the concentration of chloride ions can be decreases. And how much it is decreases? It will be calculated number of moles divided by total volume. That means 50 into 0.1 divided by 150, that gives 3.33 into 10 raised to minus 2. And if you find out their PCl minus, that is negative logarithm of Cl minus, the value becomes is equal to 1.48. Similarly, we can also find out after addition of 90 ml 0.1 molar silver nitrate solution into the 100 ml 0.1 molar NaCl solution, right? So then if we are adding a 90 ml into 100 ml, 10 ml becomes unreacted, then 90 ml will be consumed and the total volume becomes 190 ml, right? And therefore the concentration of chloride minus again decreases. That will be nothing but number of millimoles divided by total volume. Millimoles of Cl minus is 10 into 0.1 divided by 190, that is equal to 5.3 into 10 raised to minus 3. And if you find out PCl minus, PCl minus is equal to 2.28. So here, so now if you find out the activity of silver plus ion and activity of Cl minus ion, that is nothing but concentration of silver ion into concentration of Cl minus ion is equal to 1.2 into 10 raised to minus 10. That means the Ksp of AgCl. When the concentration of silver minus ion and concentration of chloride minus ion is more than 1.2 into 10 raised to minus 10, then precipitate of silver chloride will be formed. That means if you find out their P value, P of Ag plus in plus P of Cl minus, that is equal to 9.92. That means P of AgCl, that P of AgCl will be used a Ksp for this AgCl, right? And then the calculation after 50 ml addition of 0.1 molar silver nitrate solution, the value of PCl minus is 1.42, which is calculated in equation 1, and hence the value of PAg plus is equal to 9.92 minus 1.42, that is equal to 8.44, right? So this is the 8.44. That means in this manner the various concentration of Cl minus ion and silver plus ion can be calculated up to the equivalence point, right? And up to the equivalence point, we know that the amount of silver minus ion will be react with amount of this Cl minus ion, and we can find out the one of the concentration which is present in the solution. Either if we know the concentration of silver ion, we can find out the Cl minus ion, or if we know the concentration of Cl minus ion, we can find out the concentration of silver ion. So at the equivalence point, the concentration of silver ion is equal to concentration of Cl minus ion, and that is equal to square root of Ksp of AgCl, right? Square root of Ksp of AgCl, and that means, or we can write down P of silver is equal to P of Cl minus ion, that is equal to 1/2 of P of AgCl, because the square root we can write as a 1/2. That means 9.92 is divided by 2, that is equal to 4.96. That means at equivalence point, the activity of silver ion or activity of this Cl minus ion is equal to 4.96, and this is the equivalence point. But after addition of 100.1 ml of 0.1 molar silver nitrate solution, that means the total 100 ml will be consumed with this Cl minus ion and this silver ion. The 0.1 ml of 0.1 molar silver nitrate will be remains as it is, and here the silver ion will be present in excess concentration, and its concentration is nothing but millimoles divided by total volume. Total volume is 100 plus 100.1, that is equal to 200.1, and therefore millimoles of silver ion, 0.1 into 0.1, that is equal to 5 into 10 raised to minus 5. And therefore P of Ag plus is equal to 4.30, P of Cl minus is equal to P of AgCl, and P of Ag plus is equal to 9.92 minus 4.30 is equal to 5.62. Right? This is the after equivalence point, and therefore in this way we can find out the concentration before the equivalence point, concentration after the equivalence point, and concentration at the equivalence point. So these reactions are used to study how to determine the equivalence point in precipitation titration. Then determination of end point in precipitation titration. In precipitation titration, how we can determine the end point? Similar in acid base titration, complexometric titration, and redox titration, the indicator which shows color change at equivalence point, that is called as the end points, right? And therefore in precipitation titration there is also a indicator is required to determine the end point, and therefore several methods are used to determine the end point, but some of them discussed below. That means a formation of color precipitate, one of the method is to determine the end point is called as a formation of color precipitate. That means the color of the solutions will be changed, and that will be the end point of the solution. So this is an example of Mohr's method, or we can say that this is a type of Mohr's method, and there chromate salt like potassium chromate is added as an indicator. Here potassium chromate can be used as an indicator to determine the end point, that is called as a Mohr's method. Precipitation of chloride is complete the first excess of silver ion will be react with the indicator to precipitate the red silver chromate. Because here if we are adding a chromate ion, that is a potassium chromate in the solution, then initially the silver ion will be react with this chromate ion and give silver chromate, and which is red color, right? But after equivalence point, this silver will be removed from this chromate ion and it will be react with this silver chromate, and this potassium chromate will be remains as it is in the solution. Here the reaction is chromate will be react with this silver ion, it gives formation of silver chromate, and the chromate which is yellow in color, but as soon as it form complex with this silver ion, it gives a red color. That means the end point is either yellow to red or it is a red to yellow. And in this type, the concentration of indicator is again important. The salt silver chromate should just start precipitating at the equivalence point, because if the excess addition of silver ion in the solution will be combined with this chromate ion, and that gives a end point from yellow to red, right? Then from KSP value, that is solubility product of silver chromate, the concentration of silver ion at equivalence point is 10⁻⁵. Therefore, silver chromate should precipitate just when the silver ion is 10⁻⁵ molar. That means a little excess concentration, how much? 10⁻⁵ molar is added in the solution. It gives formation of a chromate, silver chromate, and that will be red in color, and that is the end point of titration. And the solubility product for this silver chromate is 1.1 × 10⁻¹². That means this is nothing but the silver chromate. When it will be dissociated, it gives 2Ag++Cr₄₂-, and therefore KSP is equal to, it is the product of ionic concentration raised to appropriate power, that is the concentration of Ag plus bracket square into concentration of Cr₄₂-, and therefore the concentration of chromate ion is nothing but KSP upon concentration of silver ion bracket square, right? So this is nothing but 1.1 × 10⁻¹² divided by 10⁻⁵ bracket square, that is equal to 0.11. This is the chromate ion concentration, and therefore the concentration of chromate ion is greater than this. Silver chromate will begin to precipitate when Ag plus is less than 10⁻⁵, that is before the equivalence point. Before the equivalence point, silver chromate should not be precipitated, and therefore it does not give any color, but little excess concentration of this chromate ion added in the solution, it gives formation of silver chromate and it gives red color. That is nothing but the end point of titration. And if chromate ion is less than 0.11 molar, then silver ion will have to exceed 10⁻⁵ molar, that means beyond the equivalence point and before the precipitate of silver chromate begins. So in actual practice, the indicator concentration is kept 0.002 to 0.005 molar, so that it only gives a color change instead of formation of the precipitate of silver chromate, right? So this is the required condition when we are using indicator in the redox in the precipitation titration. That is, the indicator concentration should be kept moderate, that is in between 0.002 to 0.005 molar. If it is much higher than this, then the intense yellow color of the chromate ion observed, the red color of silver chromate precipitate color, and an excess of silver ion is required to produce enough precipitate to be seen. And if there is concentration of chromate ion is excess, then it gives a red precipitate of silver chromate. And if we want to see the red precipitate, then the silver ion is required more to produce the red precipitate, so that we can easily see. And therefore this is the not case, and that means if we did not get at exact equivalence point, so indicator blank should always be determined and subtracted from the titration to correct for the indicator error. So this is again one main method where we can use a indicator blank, that means which can be used to determine the exact equivalent point, and it can be subtracted from the, that is, blank determination, and then correct endpoint can be easily determined. So the Mohr's method is preferred over the pH value 8. That means pH is also important here. That means we have to maintain the pH of the solution is 8. If the pH of the solution is too acidic, that means below the pH 6, then the part of indicator is present as a perchromate ion, right? And if more silver ion will be required to form the precipitate of silver chromate, that means below the pH 6, there is more and more silver chromate ion is required, silver ion is required to form the precipitate of silver chromate. And above the pH 8, silver hydroxide may be precipitated. That means we have to maintain the pH value 8 so that we can get equivalence point, because before the pH value 8, that means below 6, it requires more silver ion to precipitate of silver chromate, because below the pH 6, the chromate ion will be present in terms of perchromate ion, that is SCrO4 minus, and therefore above the pH value, above the pH 8, silver hydroxide may also precipitate, and therefore the pH is properly maintained by adding the solid calcium carbonate to the solution. We can maintain the pH nearly equal to 8. So this is the one of the indicator which is used to determine in precipitation titration. Second type of indicator is called as a formation of a soluble colored compounds. Formation of soluble color compound. So this is an example of Wollard's method, or we can say that this type of titration is also called as a Wollard's method. In Wollard's method, this is indirect method of titration for determining anions, and that precipitate with silver as a chloride, bromide or iodide in presence of acid solution. So here in this method, an excess of silver nitrate is added to precipitate the anion, and the excess of silver ion is determined by back titration with standard potassium thiocyanate solution. Here we are adding excess of silver ion in the solution, and then excess of silver ion can again titrated, back titrated by using a potassium thiocyanate solution, and that can be shown by equation X minus plus Ag plus, it gives formation of a AgX, and the excess of silver ion is present in the solution, and that excess of silver ion titrated with this potassium thiocyanate solution, it gives formation of silver thiocyanate precipitate. And the end point of this titration is detected by adding iron 3 as a ferric ammonium sulfate, it is also called as a ferric alum, and which form red colored complex with the first excess of titrant. That means if there is excess of silver ion present in the solution, the Fe3 ion or ferric ammonium sulfate can form red color complex with this excess of this silver ion. It gives Fe3 plus plus HCN minus, it gives iron thiocyanate, and this iron thiocyanate will be used if the precipitate of silver halide is there, is less soluble than this silver thiocyanate, or it is equally soluble, then it is not required to remove the precipitate. That means if the precipitate is less soluble, then there is, or sometimes equally soluble, then there is no required to remove the precipitate from the solution. And in such case where the iodide ion, bromide or thiocyanate ion, in the case of iodide ion, the indicator is not added until the all iodide ion is precipitated, since it will be oxidized by the iron, because iodine is easily oxidized by iron, and therefore indicator in the determination of iodide ion, indicator will be added after the complete precipitation of the silver iodide, that is iron alum, that is ferric alum is added after the complete precipitation. If the precipitate is more soluble than silver thiocyanate, then it will be react with the titrant to give a high and diffuse endpoint. Such is case with silver chloride precipitate. That means if the precipitate is more soluble than this silver thiocyanate, then the titrant to give high and diffuse endpoint, because in silver chloride its precipitate is more soluble than this silver thiocyanate, and it gives formation of a AgCl plus thio, because this silver chloride is more soluble, and therefore thiocyanate ion will be combined with this Ag plus, and it gives a silver thiocyanate. And in this case, this AgCl is necessary to remove the precipitate before titration. That means if they were titrating this Cl minus with Ag plus, as soon as precipitate is formed, we have to filter the precipitate, and then we have to determine the excess of silver ion present in the solution, right? So it is necessary that these indicator must not form a precipitate with the titrant that is more stable than the titration precipitate, or the color reaction would occur when the first drop of titrant is added. So this is the condition. So it is necessary to form the color reactions when the first drop of titrant is added, it must give a color precipitate. Then the third type of indicator is called as an adsorption indicator. What is adsorption indicator? Adsorption indicators nothing but the indicators reaction takes place on the surface of the precipitate. When we are adding the indicator, the reaction will be takes place on the surface of the precipitate, and the indicator is nothing but these are the dyes exist in the solution in ionized form, usually an ion that is called as the ion minus, that is indicator minus. Consider the titration of this chloride with silver ion. Here the adsorption indicator will be adsorbed on the surface of precipitate, generally a dyes that will be present in the ionic form, that is in ion minus in the solution. And suppose we are considering the example of this titration between silver ion and chloride ion. So before the equivalence point, the titration, there are excess of chloride ion present which are attracted toward the positive silver ion of the precipitate, right? And as a result, they adsorb on the surface of precipitate, giving the negative charge, right? That means there is excess of Cl minus ion, and over that, the before the equivalence point, because the AgCl is there, and the formation of precipitate at AgCl, and excess of Cl minus is present and in the solution, right? And therefore, it will be the negatively charged surface repel the negative fluorescein ion, and therefore keep the ion in solution. That means, if the negative ion is surrounded by the precipitate, and therefore the negative fluorescein or the indicator ion therefore keeps the ion in the solution as it is. Then after the equivalence point, there is excess of silver ion because complete silver precipitate is formed and the silver ion is present in excess form, and these are surrounded by this precipitate, and therefore the attracted toward the silver chloride precipitate to yield positively charged surface. So it use a positively charged surface, and we know that the indicator present in anionic form, that is ion minus, it will be easily attracted toward the positive surface of the silver chloride after the equivalence point, and therefore it will be shows a color change, right? So since there is no longer repulsion between the fluorescein anion, that is Fl I minus indicator, and the precipitate particle, the indicator, that is Fl minus, adsorb on the precipitate with resulting change in color of the precipitate from white to pink, because it is attracted toward the positively surface of this silver chloride, and it gives a color change from white to pink. Since fluorescein solutions are green yellow, because the fluorescein indicator is green yellow, the observed changes form a green yellow solution to pink precipitate. That is the end point of titration, when green yellow solution becomes pink. The adsorption is reversible. The dye is being desorbed upon the back titration with chloride ion. As soon as there is excess of chloride ion present, then the fluorescein desorbs on the surface, and again it gives its original color, that is green yellow, and therefore pink color will be disappear. That means the reaction is reversible, and therefore we can get a back indicator in the solution. So some of the commonly used indicators which are listed here for the adsorption indicators, so these are indicators, that is fluorescein, which can be used for the titration of chloride with AgCl with silver ion, but the pH is we have to maintain 7 to 8. Then bromocrystal green is also there, which can be used to determine the thiocyanate ion with silver ion, and pH is we have to maintain 4 to 5. Then eosin is the indicator which can use to determine the bromide ion, iodine and thiocyanate ion. We have to maintain the pH 2, and methyl halide is also there, and rhodamine 6G is also there. That means there are different indicators can also use as a adsorption indicator, which can be adsorbed on the surface and which can show the color change. But we have to keep in mind that the particular indicators can also use for the some elements that can give a better result, but again we have to maintain the pH values, right? So friends, what we discussed today, what is precipitation, titration, and what are the indicators which are used in the precipitation, titration. Let us stop here. The remaining part will be discussed in next lecture. Thank you.